Well, in the first part of the programme, we've been discussing some of the problems of Liverpool, but Liverpool has one very particular problem, a very serious one, in that its rate of unemployment is about twice the national average figure. Now, one man whose job, in a sense, is to try and do something about that is David Mowat, who's Liverpool's Industrial Development Officer. How have you found the job of trying to persuade industries to come to Liverpool? Has it been difficult?
It's been a normal sales and marketing job in many respects. It's a question of advertising for companies and assisting companies who want to expand or develop in the Liverpool area. All right, at least half of the companies we deal with are local companies who want to expand. That's to be understood because we're in an industrial area. The other half are companies who are in other parts of the United Kingdom or overseas who are considering Liverpool for expansion or new developments.
What about when people read in their newspapers or see on television stories about strikes in Liverpool of the kind that are on at the moment? How does that affect your job?
I would imagine that they put it into perspective, as I would suggest all the people in this meeting would put them into perspective and realise that the stoppages, which you've spent some time discussing, represent less than 1% of the workforce who are employed in Liverpool and work every day without any trouble.
Eric Heffer, you were telling me that as an industry minister, you found that this was a problem, that firms did have a belief that coming to Liverpool was taking a chance.
Well, yes, because this television programme will be seen by certain employers in the south of England, and they will also read in the papers, played up on every occasion, every time there's a dispute in Merseyside. And so when the Department of Industry, because the Department of Industry does induce firms to come here, it is a special development area, there are all sorts of subsidies available, all sorts of grants and assistance, and some employers say, oh, I'm not going to Merseyside, there's always strikes.
It's not
and
just
one has to try and point out that the position on Merseyside is no worse than in other parts of the country.
It's not just the Southern Press, though, is it, Mr. Heffer? I mean, the Liverpool Daily Post this morning writes an editorial about the threat to Liverpool, to Merseyside's industrial relations.
Well, the day the Liverpool Daily Post fails to write an editorial saying that we're on the point of total collapse and industry is going to flee from this particular part of the world, that day I shall cheer.
Let's go to an employer in the audience, Mr. Bill Shanklin from BICC Cables. Now, you've been an employer on Merseyside, your company's been an employer on Merseyside for a very long time. How have you found it here? Have there been any particular problems?
Well, as you say, we have been an employer on Merseyside for a long time, I think, getting on for nearly 100 years. We employ many, many, many more people than numbers that you stated earlier. I think somewhere around 11,000 in Merseyside at the moment. I've been with my company now, BICC, for 25 years. In that time, the 11,000 people have never been on strike. There's a factory not 3 minutes from where we're sitting now, in which we employ 6,000 people. That factory hasn't been in strike in this decade or in the last 10 years.
Now, we heard earlier that it's often the case that employers don't understand the workforce, that they don't treat them, they don't lead them, they don't give them the respect, they don't consult them. What do you feel that you've done right that perhaps other employers might copy?
We've done all these things that you're saying we should do. We work hard at industrial relations. If you're in an area where men are prepared to work hard, where men are prepared to play hard, and where men are tough, and where men are intelligent, you can't treat them like boys or like children. You work hard at industrial relations. In order to work hard at industrial relations, you need good management. And in BICC, I think we've got good management.
I think, if I may,
because I believe that's probably some of the BICC employees who are applauding. And if I may, we involve them in the decisions that we are about to make that play a part in their working environment. We discuss matters with them, and we do not make decisions until these discussions have been held. That is not a sign of politics. It's not a sign of any belief in any political philosophy. It's only a sign in a belief of that is a symptom of good management.
But we live in an area, and I think you've got to remember this, that's had double the national unemployment figures ever since the First World War, and even before then. so that the insecurity of Liverpool has been seen by some employers as an area of hyper-exploitation. It was a low-wage level area for some considerable time, and so battles have been fought in the past to elevate the whole situation. The point has been made about the transformation of Dockland away from a highly labour-intense industry into a highly capital-intense industry, a reduction of more than half of the workforce in a decade. Now, those problems aren't easily overcome, and the man who feels the progress is sending him to join the dole queue resists that situation. And we haven't had the sort of compensation in job opportunities that are necessary in dealing with the obsolescence of the old industries that's occurring in this part of the world. And so this is why we believe, in fact, that there has to be an understanding of the problems in Merseyside for anyone who really wants to get involved in the Merseyside situation.
So
the workforce in Liverpool, in that sense, and examples have been given, is no different from a work point of view than any other part of the United Kingdom or indeed any other part of the world.
So your message would be, briefly, take some effort to get to understand your workforce.
Exactly.
Well, let's have some views from the audience again on this. If a firm was thinking of coming to Liverpool, what would you as workers say about that?
Well, our conditions, you know, that would be acceptable in relation to wages. There seems to be, you know, as a duck shop steward, we must make reference to what Eddie Lloyden said, where technology we've accepted, the reduction of labour for us has been assisted by a situation of severance. You know, this seems to alleviate the problem, but which management, national-wise, seems to impose to get down to what they reckon a level of employment that would suit technology. But go back also to the other thing, where management, you know, we have been at peace to a point within the Port of Liverpool, is that we want ship owners and etc. and their agents to use this port. But here we have a situation now where it's highlighted all over the media, you know, and it's given that we are the bad guys, you know. But if I may expound on the situation.
Well, can I just bring you back?
No, hang on a bit.
Well, just a minute. The point
here you're talking about management.
Yeah, but the point
that we've got bad management here.
Well, just a minute. I asked you what you would say to an employer who wanted to come to Liverpool, and you said, I think, okay, come along as long as you're willing to pay the right rate for the job.
Yeah. And I must make reference to what the Leyland lad said. If we have an agreement, we stand by it, and we, as representatives of the workforce, tell them to stand by it.
There's a point here I'd like to come back to our panel on, because in a lot of areas, we've touched on this, in a lot of areas of high unemployment, that would be seen as something that would depress the level of wages. Now, Eric Hefford, does that in fact happen in Liverpool or not?
What, you mean keeping to the trade union agreements?
I mean, a lot of employers would feel that if there was high unemployment in an area, you could probably move in and get away with paying lower wages.
Well, of course, some employers think it's a golden opportunity. Move in to an area of high unemployment, pay lower wages, and this is wonderful.
Does it work in Liverpool?
Of course it doesn't work in Liverpool, and it doesn't work for the simple reason that the Liverpool workers have been unionised for a long time, have a long understanding of trade union practices and rights, and are not prepared to easily accept lower wages vis-a-vis anywhere else. Let me give you an example. In my industry, the industry I worked in most of my life, the construction industry, there were two places which had the high level of wages compared to anywhere else. One was London and the other was Liverpool, and it still exists. That's the premier wage rate in the construction industry. Why? Because the Liverpool workers, even in the 30s, with mass unemployment amongst construction workers, would not accept lower wages and worse conditions than any other part of the country. I think that's something to be applauded. I don't think there's anything wrong with that. I think that's something which people should be proud of, the fact that workers are prepared to work for proper wages and conditions. Now, any employer who's prepared to accept that is welcome in this area and will get the fullest cooperation with the trade union movement. And I think that is the point that has to be made.
Could I please be allowed just to come back?
Well, it'll have to be very brief.
For 1 minute, I do not accept at all that management come into a development area, whether it be this or any other development area, with a view to employing cheap labour. These days have gone.
On that
and
point,
management
gentlemen,
are not
on that
like
point,
that.
Gentlemen, we have to leave it. Thank you all very much indeed.